I've shown the natural changes over the course of a year. Now I'd like to highlight some long-term changes along the lake and around Edgemere Island. The middle of the lake has UMass Medical Center, White City Shopping, apartment complexes, and new condo developments. The South Lake is also feeling the pressure of urbanization. The camps had been replaced by larger year-round dwellings. Larger homes and multifamilies are now replacing the cottages or squeezing into any open space. So far, the center of Edgemere Island has been mostly unchanged over the last 60 or so years, but along the shoreline, the change is constant, becoming increasingly crowded and gentrified. Smaller cottages have disappeared, perhaps a vestige of an earlier time, replaced by mansions or multiple-story buildings, sometimes packed together. Here a neighbor's garage is as big as this cottage. Parking area towers over it, blocking the view to the north. Whoa, wonder if you could hand a drink across to the other stairway. When the Irish Dam in Grafton raised the water several feet, it necessitated the construction of walls to hold the water back. Historically, a glacier carved out the river valley, leaving high, sedimentary stone cliffs, while depositing sand and gravel along the shoreline and lake bed. This is what it's been built on. Here are some of the man-made walls on the Worcester side of my kayak room. Along the lake are all kinds of walls, rustic, concrete, wooden, circular with flowers, or multi-level. If your backyard is the wall, make it fancy. They can be very tall, supporting huge buildings and overhanging decks. Usually there is little actual shoreline as walls are built into or close to the lake, sometimes too close. It can feel like I'm in a canyon, looking up at fortresses opposing the encroaching water. With all those walls come stairs by the hundred. Years with Daddy and Mommy. Stairs. Simple to complex to monumental. Can you imagine climbing back up to the house when you forgot something? Even a small single-story cottage on the shoreline can use some stairs. Sometimes when your plot plan's a tad too big, your house, a creative contractor can fix it by building a new wall at low tide, of course, reclaiming some of the land lost to the dammed water. Here are postcards showing the lost shoreline and beaches on Salt Lake and Sigmund. These islands would have become submerged. I hope Shrewsbury can avoid the overcrowding typical of the Worcester side. My fear is that all the cottages and smaller family dwellings will be swallowed up in the urbanization and gentrification of southern Lake Winsigamond and Edgemere having its character change forever, with mansions or condos crowded together but unaffordable to most. The wildlife has seemingly adapted to human influence. Bald eagles introduced at Drake Island have moved to a quieter location but still patrol the area. Waterfowl find quiet nooks to hatch and raise their young. Let's turn eastward towards Sunset Beach. Now to check in on the Swan family that I've been photographing each month. They frequent Meadowbrook, a Quinsigamond River tributary. My, the cygnets have grown. Flying back to Lake Quinsigamond. Don't you cry. Traveling back in time to August 2015 in my favorite spot on Flint Pond. Unfortunately, the lotus have succumbed to herbicides. And you take to the sky. But till that morning, there's nothing can harm you. Stay.